Okay, everyone, welcome back to another video. Today's video is not a figure review or a collecting video today. Today I am actually redoing my shelves, and just one part of my shelf right now, and it's this. This is my prequel shelf. This is episode 1, 2, and 3. Now, the reason why I'm doing redoing my shelves today, I just actually redid episode 1 and 2 not too long ago, but I've been wanting to do this for a while and get some of this, and I got some of this yesterday at the store, and it's sticky tack or fun tack, and this makes figures stand better, you know, the figures that can't stand better, such as I'll show you a few. Here's just my episode 2 figures, such as this Padme figure. She's in her wedding dress, but her feet are lower than her gown is, so she can't stand. And I don't have her stand to make her stand, so sticky tack would do figures for like this. Same with this Padme, she can't really stand on her own either. Same with this one, she can, but then she'll fall over once you put other figures around her. Padme's like this one, she can't stand by herself. You know, figures in big gowns such as, you know, Queen Amidala's and stuff, she can't stand by herself. She doesn't need sticky tack. Nuke Gunray, he can stand by himself too. He doesn't need sticky tack. Now, figures like Darth Sidious, now sometimes he has trouble standing. As you can see, he's falling over, so sticky tack would do good for him, just so, you know, you can stand him up, you know, while you're putting other figures together. Now I only got 2 packs of this stuff, and I think I might need more. This is my episode 1, 2, and 3 figures. So I was going to get to a few more, but I only had so much money to spend. So you know, it's cheap. It's only $1.97, you know, $2 in tax, $2-something. Now, I'm only starting on my prequel shelves. This is my OT collection and small expanded universe collection. As you can see on all of the shelves, they are kind of tightly together, and that's how the prequels were too. So I'm kind of hoping, I only can hope, that maybe, you know, the tack will let me maybe give each figure a little space. Now, these are wall shelves. They're 2 different wall shelves, so there's not much room. I do eventually want to get bigger shelves like this, but bigger, with like, you know, 6 shelves on it or something. So I've been using these wall shelves for quite a few years for my collection, and I like them because, you know, it's episode 3, you know, 3 shelves on 1. So you know, I'm hoping maybe I could space them out, you know, a little bit, so they're not all squeezed together like the original trilogy is. Now, if I have enough, which I'm going to try my best to save some, I'll do the OT next. But I think for now I'm just going to do the prequels, and then next time I'm at Walmart, get some more. Now, I actually did have some, and a little bit. I got it from a friend or something, not sure, but it's white kind. Now, I did use some for my episode 3 figures. I used some for my Padme in her nightgown, because, you know, she doesn't, you can, sometimes if you play with her, she can stand, but, you know, I want her to stand up all the time, so I used some on Brie Halagana, because she stands, but usually she leans forward. Again, if you play with her, you can get her to stand. I also used some on my, now, as I said, most of the Queen Amidala figures stand up, but this one didn't stand up really well. She she can stand, but she leans forward. So I want to stand straight like that. I did have one problem, a couple of problems with this kind of sticky tack. Because I think these two kinds are different. When I was taking them down, because I noticed the white kind kind of left some marks on my shelf. So it can probably be a little hard to get off. And also, I did use some on my episode 3 Ada from the Vintage Collection, but as I saw when I was taking her down to put her with the other figures, she was about right here, and I pulled her off, and there was some sticky tack left on her foot. And you can get most of it off. Sometimes it's a little harder, but I noticed some of it got in her peg hole, and I got most of it out. You can't really see, but I noticed she couldn't stand on her stand anymore. Likely, you know, she has two holes, and luckily I don't use stands for my movie figures. So you gotta be careful with that and put it in a place where it won't get in the hole. Now hopefully I can get it out, you know, in time. So you know, as I said, as time, if I do have more, I'll start with episode 4 and work my way up. But for now, I'm just doing the prequels, as you guys know. The prequels are my favorite thing about Star Wars. Even then, I don't think I'll have enough for every single figure. But as I said, like, figures like T-Don Me-Don here, he doesn't need a sticky tack. Not all the figures need sticky tack. Because some figures just stand fine without it, and they don't fall. Now, figures like this Darth Maul, he doesn't really need sticky tack either, because he can stand fine, and I usually put him back here anyway. You know, that's where I usually keep him, or, you know, on the side, because this figure works best on the corners, behind someone, and he's big. Now, figures like, you know, as I said, Padme's with big gowns like this can stand on her own. You know, she doesn't need tack. Now some figures like this Anakin, you know, he may need tack. He came with a vehicle, but I don't have the vehicle yet. He's gonna need tack. This Count Dooku, now you never know with figures, you know, he may need tack. You know, he can stand well, but it's just to, you know, the point where these shelves are pretty crowded, and when you're setting up other figures that are standing perfectly fine tend to fall over. Now, there are a few Episode 1 figures I have that can't stand, and I have to actually put in the back because they can't stand. And I'm going to try to find him, and here he is. And this is one perfect example. Kiadi Mundi from the Episode 1-9. Now, I usually always put him in the back anyway, because he is a bigger figure. But as you can see, that's the only way I could display him, is if I have him in the back, because he can stand perfectly fine, because he's up against the railing. But if you try to, you know, I'm sure after a while, you can play with him. Like, there, I got him to stand, but then his leg is weird. So there's that. So, you know, as I said, the only figures that you stand are my Clone Wars figures. Then this is just other random stuff. And then I don't use any stands for my other non-Star Wars figures. So, you know, let me know what you guys use to display your figures with. If you use sticky tack, or you just have your figures stand there, or you use stands. I like stands, but if I use stands for every figure, it would take up a lot of room. Like here, the OCC stand, as you can see, they do take up quite a bit of room, and so there wouldn't be room for the figures to stand. I'm already running out of room on each shelf, as you can see. Actually, for example, my episode 6 collection is overflowing. They always fall. I mean, which is fine because it's on the bed here, but it does get kind of annoying. So, let me know what you use. I'm going to be busy all day with this. It usually takes me a few hours to even set up figures by themselves because they do usually fall. So, I will do a video. Maybe depends how it turns out on how it looks. It might take me longer because of the tag. So, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe to my channel, and as always, may the force be with you. Bye.